So the first pillar that we're going to make is going to be the triangle one. For that, we're going to take an A4 sheet. For that A4 sheet, I want you to turn and fold it into three halves. So let's fold this over here. This is going to be your first half. And let's fold the other side on it. This is going to be your other part. So now that you can see, once I open it, it's divided into three folds. One, two, and three. There are three parts. Now after you open it, I want you to hold the paper end to end. And I want you to put sellotapes and close this end. Start putting sellotapes from this side to this end. Put as many sellotapes as possible. I usually prefer to put 8, 2 on the ends and 6 in the middle, so that is properly secure and your pillar is strong. So let's first put the two ends. So I've put it on this end and let's put on the other end. Now I'm going to put a few more, 5-6 in the middle. So I'm going to just keep it on the table. Now that the sides are done, so let's put one in the middle and let's put two more on these sides. So now that I've put five, I'm going to put two more so that it's strong enough. Just wherever you can see there's a lot of opening, put a sellotape there. I'm going to put one more here. I feel that there's a lot of space there. So this is your first pillar. You can see it's a triangle. I'm going to keep this aside. Now I'm going to take the next paper. With this, we're going to make it a square pillar. So how to make a square pillar from this? First step is going to be fold this paper into half. Okay, now we're going to open it. As you can see, it's folded into half. Now let's take one end of the paper and fold it into half, but only till the middle. The fold that you made. Okay, it's going to be like a door. So let's take the other end and fold it into half only till the middle. As you can see, it's going to be like this. And it's divided into four parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. And like we did for the triangle one, once you open it, I want you to fold it into half so that you have two ends. And put sellotape so that you shut this end. Again, two in the corner and a few in the middle. So let's put some sellotape, one for one end, second for the other end. Now we can keep it and put a few over here so that it's strong enough. So I'm going to put one in the middle. Let's put two over here. Now your square pillars ready. Just gonna tighten the edges and I'm gonna keep this aside. For the last one, the circular pillar, let's take the last A4 sheet that we have, turn it into a pipe. Very simple, and put some sellotape here. So again, so now let's try to make them stand. Okay, so first one, let's take the first one that we built. And now you can see it's triangle when you see it from the top. It's standing well. Let's take the other one. Now you can see this is a square from top. That's why we're calling it a square pillar. And next is the circular pillar. It's circle from the top. When you see from the top, This is a triangle one, this is a square pillar, and this is a circular pillar. Now, we're going to take each pillar at one time, stack some books on it, and... So first, let's try the triangular pillar. So I'm going to keep it, and I've taken the thinnest and the smallest book first. Let's try to keep it almost in the middle. Taking the weight, let's try another book. It fell. So what? I want you to remember the books that you used and see in which order you put. I want you to put them in the same order for the next one. So this could hold one book, and when you put the second one, it fell down. Let's try for the square pillar. So I've taken this one. So let's again. So this is the first book that I've put. I'm going to use. And bang, just like the triangular one. The same thing happened for this one. Okay, let's see what happens to this circle one. One, and bang. Wow! Let's see what happened to the third one. Whoa! Three books! I'm out of books, guys. This is the last one. Wow, I need to grab a few more. Okay, I'm going to grab a few more. I've put the fifth book. Wow, this is crazy. The square one is the strongest. I don't know how is this happening. Wow, this is the fattest book that I could find. Oh, oh. So let's count how many books it could hold. One, two, three. 4, 5, 6 books. And do you all now want to know why was it so different? Why the triangular one almost fell when you put the second one? The square one almost was holding 2 books, but after some time it fell. And the circle one, oops, it's broken. The circle one could almost hold 6 books. So why is this one the strongest? Do you want to know? Are you curious like I was? Let's go and see.